Who knew that a simple advertisement could cause so much trouble? 29 candidates applied for the position, but only 9 turned up to give the test. On 10 parameters, 8 of the 9 got between 0 and 2 marks. Only one candidate stood out, 10 on 10, and was appointed professor of Sanskrit at the Banares Hindu University. The student should have been a happy lot to get someone good, right? Instead, they protested.
Will a non-Hindu teacher teach us our own religion?
Sanskrit Vidya Dharma Vigyan or Sanskrit Literature and Hindu Theology students staged a sit-in at the Vice Chancellor's office and boycotted classes, leading to a violent confrontation that required police intervention. Meet Dr. Firoz Khan, the Bagru Rajasthan-born 28-year-old Sanskrit scholar, the man at the center of this furor. Bachelor of Arts, Bachelor of Education, Master of Arts and a PhD in Sanskrit from the Rashtriya Sanskrit Sansthan, Jaipur, a renowned center of learning that taught Sanskrit, the Vedas, astronomy and other disciplines of traditional Hindu theology. This autonomous university was given an A rank by the government, similar to the BHU itself, or Deccan College, Jadavpur University, Jamia Millia, and the Vellore Institute of Technology. Sanskrit is taught in 2 departments at the BHU. The Arts Department teaches classical Sanskrit as a language, and the Sanskrit Vidya Dharma Vigyan run it in the Gurukul style, where both Sanskrit literature and Hindu theology are taught. But protests are happening only in the Gurukul and not the Arts Department. That's because those who study theology are understandably devout, conservative Hindus and follow customs like keeping a choti and conducting ceremonial rituals like havans and yagnas. For them, teachers are not only those who teach a course, but are gurus who guide their spiritual lives.
And according to whom?
A Muslim cannot possibly be a guru to them and expect to keep Vedic traditions pure. Ironically, Khan has been appointed Assistant Professor of Literature in the Dharma Vigyan Department and will teach only Sanskrit literary epics. They have nothing to do with religion.
I could have understood their protests if I had been asked to teach the Vedas, Hindu scriptures or astrology.
Rajesh Kochar writes in his book, The Vedic People, Their History and Geography, how during the Mughal era, Brahmin pandits from Banaras instructed Prince Dara Sikho in Sanskrit. Impressed with the Mughals' exalted position and love of learning, they together translated the 52 Upanishads to Persian. More recently, Muslim Sanskrit scholar Pandit Gulam Dastagir Birajdar taught the language across various educational institutions including BHU without facing any backlash. The 85-year-old Mumbaikar is presently the chairman of the committee to prepare school textbooks for Sanskrit in Maharashtra. Incidentally, Birajdar's command over the language made him such an authority on Hindu theological traditions that he's often requested by Hindus to teach them how to perform rituals.
Panditji, can you solemnize my son's marriage?
Panditji, please perform the last rites ceremony for my father.
Similarly, another Muslim Sanskrit scholar, Dr. Muhammad Hanif Khan, recently retired as professor at Varanasi's Rashtriya Sanskrit Sansthan. And he's tried to bring the two religions closer through his doctorate thesis.
Comparative analysis of the Gayatri Mantra and Surah Al-Fatiha.
He was bestowed an honorary title by the former President of India, Dr. Shankar Dayal Sharma.
From now on, you will be known as Shastri.
Meaning someone who knows the Shastras. By the way, can you tell us the meaning of these common Hindu surnames? Dvivedi, Trivedi, Chaturvedi? It simply means someone who knew 2, 3 or 4 of the Vedas by heart. There was a time when Sanskrit was the exclusive preserve of the upper castes. But the walls were broken around 1000 AD when Shudras like Raja Bhoj and Raja Bharatri emerged as Sanskrit scholars in their own right.
Then in British times, this monopoly was rapidly eroded when Brahmins sold ancient Sanskrit manuscripts to the colonial masters in exchange for money and patronage. Moreover, Western students have been enrolling in these very courses at BHU since decades, and no objection has ever been taken.
The protesters disagree and refer to a plaque installed by the founder of the BHU, Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya,
studying or teaching in the Sanskrit Vidya Dharma Vigyan school is meant exclusively for Hindus and their religious equivalents.
Conspicuously leaving out Muslims but naming benefits to other South Asian religions.
But the inscription dates back to India's pre-independence era and BHU management has dug its heels in.
India's constitution forbids discrimination on the basis of religion.
And refused to fire the newly appointed professor.
His appointment has been done correctly and fairly according to the rules.
Besides, BHU's Urdu department was twice headed by Hindus. Maulvi Mahesh Prasad, a Hindu scholar of Islam for 30 years, and later by Professor Hukum Chand Nayyar for another 15.
Religion and language are two totally different things.
With their protests along communal lines leading nowhere, the students opened a new front against their HOD.
There is nepotism and corruption in the process of appointment.
They accuse Professor Chaturvedi of filling positions at BHU with his own gang of scholars from the Rashtriya Sanskrit Sansthan, his previous employer. As can be expected, the main faces of the anti-Khan agitation are all linked to the BJP or its student wing, the Akhil Bharatiya Vidyarthi Parishad. And the scholars at the receiving end of the ire are being called leftists. Vice Chancellor Professor Rakesh Bhatnagar is among those being labeled leftist just because he once taught at JNU. In September this year, a similar group of students affiliated to Hindu political outfits protested the decades-old passage of a Muharram procession through the campus. Radical outfits use fake scare tactics like these to get support.
The procession is a ploy to Islamize the Hindu university. A time will come when non-Hindus will be in charge of Hindu Dharma Vigyan. Muslims breed so much that they will soon outnumber Hindus.
Students of the BHU have also split along political ideological lines, and most others have distanced themselves from the actions of the theology students.
The real mark of a scholar is his scholarship and not his religion.
A similar incident had occurred in May 2019 at Harvard University, USA, when a celebrated black professor, Ron Sullivan, was dismissed after student protests. Dr. Khan was initially thrilled to be offered the position, but he's now gone into hiding and switched off his mobile.
Considering the danger to his life, will he even take up the position now?
Moreover, the row over Dr. Firoz Khan's appointment will certainly not be the last of these communal flare-ups engineered by Hindu radical groups.
Bisbo's limerick. Firoz Khan became professor of Sanskrit at BHU. But he was Muslim, so trouble brew. Because they got confused, religion and language they fused. Instead, they missed an opportunity to widen their hues. Subscribe to Bisbo and click on the bell icon to get notified whenever Bisbo releases a new video. Sources of all our information is listed in the video description section.